Secretary Bunch, thank you for joining us. We are in a moment. We were anticipating transformation, but now we are in a moment of expectancy and transformation and hurt and pain. Have we ever seen this moment before as a nation and then as Black people?
I think it's important to remember that while there have been moments where people disagreed violently, leading to the Civil War, the fact that no one has breached the Capitol since the British did it in 1814 tells us that what happened recently is really something that we've never seen. I have to be honest. I was working all day, and when I finally took a break and put on television, I couldn't believe what I was seeing. And I couldn't believe it partly because of, you know, the violence that you saw, partly because I worried that if those people were African-American, how they might be treated versus how these other people were treated. But it also made me realize that all the hope I have for America, it called that into question. Because I always thought there was a small group of Americans who, you know, we disagreed with. But I thought that the core of America was really turning that arc towards justice. Yesterday worried me for the first time that said, maybe I've been too hopeful.
Wow. So I'm asking you, as the nation's greatest historian, how will history view yesterday and even these 4 years?
Well, you know, it's hard to realize how history is going to be written, but clearly yesterday will be seen as a day of infamy. There's no doubt about that. It will be something people will write about. It'll be used to help people understand the divisions that were in America. But it will also be a time to sort of ask the fundamental question, will America ever live up to its stated ideals? Are there enough Americans who would say that that was wrong, and that in essence they would repudiate that kind of insurrection? So I think it will be something that historians will write about. Let me just say there will be 1,000 dissertations written on yesterday.
And you know, it's so interesting. Everyone has a different view. And the question is, who's right? How does history determine who's right? Or do you just collectively bring this mindset from the far right, this mindset from the far left, and this mindset from the middle, and just bring them all together to one piece of the story, to tell the story?
What happens with history is this, is that I may write it from a different lens, somebody else will write it from a different lens, and then initially we'll then say, all right, what does this tell us collectively? And what will happen is that somebody will then write a piece that will sort of subsume all the different points of view. But I think that what will be clear is that I find it hard to say that any historian will not say, this is a moment where the nation was in crisis. This is a moment that we had never expected to see in the United States. I think regardless of a historian's politics, they will say that.
I just got off a conversation with Democratic Caucus Chair Hakeem Jeffries just before our conversation. And he affirmed that they saw it coming. They knew it was coming yesterday. They dropped the ball. He said it was an operational failure. But it's a straight shot from the ellipse all the way to the Capitol. And in between is the Smithsonian, to include the Museum of African American History and Culture. Is the Smithsonian okay? Are you guys okay? Do you guys have any problems?
You know, besides being shaken like all Americans, the Smithsonian security people, the National Park Service, protected the buildings of the Smithsonian. So we're okay. And I think that's really important, because at some point, the public's going to need what the Smithsonian does. They're going to need to be able to dip into that history, to dip into that culture. So I'm grateful for my colleagues who work so hard to protect not just the buildings, not just the collections, but the memories that are in the Smithsonian.